best what he wants to say happens in the first few minutes. Okay. So the very act of meditation in society has become more important than on what we are meditating. Ask anybody, what are you meditating? I don't know. And that's, he doesn't even consider it important. So similarly, people, this is another joke, I believe. And they believe on anything they want. And it says that act of believing is more important. What you are believing is not very important. No, doesn't make sense. You are eating. What is important? Definitely, what are you eating? So this very meditation on what? That is what the guidance will come. As such, people meditate on so many things. But this chapter teaches on what to meditate. That's why it's dhyana. Dhyana yoga. Chapter 6. But you see, look at this person. Why he is doing that? Who told him to do that? This is actually torturing the body. And not only the body, the Lord resides in the body. We're giving pain to the Lord. His Supreme Lord, the loving Father is sitting. What is my child doing? Why is he doing all this kind of austerities? Who asked him to do all this thing? Look at this. Presently today, the most popular form of yoga is Ashtanga yoga, no doubt. If you type on the net, yoga means is Ashtanga yogis. And not, I've seen and I told you, Kumbhela, they are the ones, VVIPs. Is this yoga first? Now look on what all deviations it has taken. Can you look at this joke? This is called beer yoga. Can you believe this? Don't think I'm just joking. Type on the net goat yoga. You'll get many places where they do that. And people pay heavy money for all this. Goat yoga. Office yoga. You can see so many kind of yoga for pregnancy, yoga for chair yoga. And they have become specialists on all this thing. Desktop yoga, yoga for tennis, office. What is Ashtanga yoga? So this is totally gone out of the picture. The very meaning, life, the very essence of yoga has gone out. And what we are practicing is, they only know what they're practicing. They lost the very meaning. You know, this yoga day is observed all around the world. It's a good initiative. But people, they don't know who are promoting and who are doing. Nobody knows what is yoga. That's why around the world, when the big gathering happens, ISKCON devotees go with a stack of books. And they say, do you know what is yoga? See, actually, we don't know what is yoga. We thought it is some system exercise. But by common sense, you can know it has to be something more than this. But exercise means you can go to physiotherapists also. You know, but and for most of the people, yoga is nothing but more than some physiotherapy exercises. Nothing more than that. Just like I give a picture, you're climbing Tirupati Hill. Now, at the end of it, you take darshan of Balaji. But on the way, when you're going, definitely when you climb some hundreds and hundreds of steps, you feel little, you know, weight loss. You feel, you know, some refreshment for the body. And people think, that's what it is. But that's not why reason we go to Tirupati to do exercise. But some imagine a fool who climbs, say there are 500 steps to reach Balaji. And at 300 steps, they say, enough, I did it. And I enjoyed it. I'm feeling my health has improved. And he comes back. Won't that be considered foolish? The same thing as Ashtanga Yoga. Ashtanga Yoga has 8 parts. And the last part is the darshan of the Lord. But no, that is not understood in society today. People know yama, external discipline. There's a niyama, asana. See, this is what actually this chakra is not made by me. Made by these people only who have wrong understanding. You see, union integration with God. No, so samadhi doesn't mean that. Samadhi means darshan of the Lord face to face. So these are the different stages. First stage is yama. Yes. The first stage is yama. I'm explaining now each one of them. So in Bhagavad Gita, I found all the 8 stages are there. That was very interesting to me. 6.10, you should live alone in a secluded place. Control. These are some external rules and regulations. And can you see at the backside? A tiger. So the person is attracted. Generally, people are attracted and they consider this normal. Then niyamas. Temperate habits of eating. Asana, sit on the kusha grass, neither too high, neither too low. Alone in a secret place, carefully controlled mind. person should be temperate in his habits of eating, sleeping, and recreation. Asana, sit on the kusha grass, covered with the deer skin. Pranayama, practicing the breathing exercises. Pratyahara. Actually, this should come here. Yeah, now it's the correct picture. Otherwise, it gives you a wrong. This is actually the picture. Can you see this? Yeah, this is Yama. Now it's Yama. Because the objective is lost. See, that picture looks very attractive, but it is not the picture of yoga. Yama means living alone in a secluded place and always controlling the mind. Niyama, temperate in the habits of eating, sleeping. It looks so nice. Asana, sit on a kusha grass, cover the deer skin, neither too high, neither too low. Too high, too comfortable, then you sleep. Some austerity. Eyes are neither closed, neither open, half closed. If they close, again you sleep off. So there are some rules and regulations to practice. Pranayama exercises. Then cessation of material existence, pratyahara, dharana, then dhyana, and then samadhi. So gradually, it's all ending in total samadhi on the Lord. Eight stages. In my college, I know I was taught Ashtanga. I learned some steps of yoga. Everywhere you learn. But I never knew what is the meaning of this. Never knew. I never, never knew it's going to end in samadhi on the Lord. Mostly we look on yoga for some peace of mind, for good health, which are byproducts, which is not the target of yoga. Target of yoga is very clear, to take darshan of the Lord face to face. Dhana vastatketena manasa pashyanti yama yoginaha. So, are you all ready to do this yoga? We hold, suppose
yes.
We hold.
Yes.
Yes, Prabhuji. Yes,
Prabhuji. Everybody is ready? Okay.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Fantastic. You know what happened? 5,000 years, Arjuna heard this system of yoga from Krishna. And Arjuna is not an ordinary person. You know, he was a pet disciple of Dronacharya. You know the story when Guru asked him that you have to pierce the eye of the bird, eye bird. That is, Arjuna said, you know, I'm only seeing the eye of the bird. He was seeing nothing else. He was so focused. So he's a pet disciple of Dronacharya among all the Pandavas and Kauravas. You know, he was having such power of concentration that he could pierce a fish to win the hand of Draupadi in Swayamvara. That he was in the, not only in the childhood he lived in a forest, even Vanvas was in the forest, Vanavasa. He knows how to live in a forest. See, for us, to follow the rules and regulations in Ashtanga Yoga, one of the processes, you cannot do it at home. You have to go to the forest. And going to the forest is out of question for any one of us, man or woman. We live in a forest, we just don't know how to live. Our body can't take the austerity of living in a forest, in a simple place, in a cottage. But they had, in childhood also, later also, spent a lot of time, they know how to live in a forest. Arjuna knew how to, even a so skillful fighter, he pleased Lord Shiva with his fighting skill. And Arjuna is Nar Narayan Rishi. He's associate of the Lord, eternal associate of the Lord. He has lot of credentials. And after all these credentials, Arjuna says, I cannot do it. Chanchalai mana Krishna pramati balavat ridam tasyaham nigram manye vayo rivasa duskaram. Arjuna is actually a truthful person. Again, I keep reading Bhagavad Gita, you see such a great person he is. He says, Krishna, I can't do this. It's not possible for me. Why? Chanchalai mana Krishna. My mind is very restless, Krishna. It is beyond my capacity to do this process of yoga. I'm sorry. He is being very frank and honest. That I can control wind, Krishna, if you want, but I cannot control this mind. It is more difficult. For the mind is restless, turbulent, obstinate, and very strong. Krishna, And to subdue it, I think, is more difficult than controlling the wind. So Arjuna gave up. And our Acharya Srila Prabhupada says, when Arjuna gives up, please don't even think about it. Are you greater than Arjuna that he can even dream of doing this? So Arjuna gave up. So Krishna says, Arjuna, okay, this is clear. So it's very clarified by the Lord that Ashtanga Yoga process Arjuna has rejected. Okay, Arjuna with so much credentials. So we should not even think about it. Bhagavad Gita 6.34. So one who has conquered the mind, mind is best friend. One who has failed to do so, mind is the greatest enemy. Then Arjuna, being pushed by Krishna that he can do it, he says, Krishna, tell me one thing. What happens to somebody who takes up the process of spiritual life and cannot complete it? So very nicely Krishna explains that there are two situations he will get into. If he has sufficiently advanced his spiritual life, then he almost reaches the level of perfection, then 6.42 will apply. Next life, will be born in the family of great devotees. So he has a very quick opportunity for spiritual advancement. But in case no, he has not advanced much, then really after many, many years of enjoyment, planets, the pious living in it, is born into the family of righteous people or in the family of rich aristocracy. Okay, after many years of enjoyment, he will be born in the devatas. First, he will go to devatas, have little pleasant life there with comforts, and he will be born in earth, Shuchi Nam Shrimata, pious family and rich family, so that he can easily focus on spiritual life. So he gets a supplementary chance, we call in college supplementary chance in two ways. If he has very sufficiently advanced, then he will get a quick opportunity to go back to Krishna Loka. He will be born in a family of great devotees, so that quickly he can finish his business. But suppose not that much advanced, but still he has practiced spiritual life, he go to Devaloka for some time, then come back and then be in a pious Brahmana family. But the danger is that when you are born again, you may not take advantage of either of the opportunities. Therefore, Acharyas recommend to go back, not to have a plan so that this very life we go back to Krishna. Not that, okay, there is an opportunity for supplementary examination, I fail. Nobody does that. So, who is the greatest yogi? At the last shloka of the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna explains, Yogi naam api sarvesha madgata antaratmana shaddaman bhajate yamam sumayukto tamo mataha. The greatest yogi is the bhakti yogi. Yogi naam api sarvesha. Among all the yogis, madgata antaratmana. He is the greatest, always thinking about me. Shraddhavan bhajate yamam. With great faith, he is worshipping me. Same yukta tamo mata. He is the greatest yogi. So actually yoga means bhakti yoga. Karma yoga, gyan yoga, ashtanga yoga are when the mixture is there. When they are too much, somebody is proud of his profession and is attached to the result of the profession, then he becomes karma yogi. But somebody is, you know, proud of his speculation, imagination. Yesterday somebody was telling me in the class, no, God has no form. So much he was telling. Then I said, no, it's wrong. And he was a very humble person. I agreed, yes, it's wrong. But sometimes people are not reasonable. There was, I remember one person had come to temple and he was telling me, this is like that, you know, God is like that, God is like that. So I said, that's fine. I opened Bhagavad Gita. See, Bhagavad Gita doesn't speak what you are speaking. And immediately he said, I don't believe in Gita. So this is silly, you know. Person is too much proud of his own imaginations, and to some extent, he's contemplating on God. So because there is a contamination of his own speculation, that yoga doesn't become bhakti yoga, it becomes jnana yoga. Then ashtanga yoga is, the person is after some little, about some kind of siddhis, some power that got. Therefore, that doesn't become bhakti yoga, it's called ashtanga yoga. Another way we look at it is, in the beginning, say a person is, what is he doing? He's working hard, he gets some money and he's enjoying. That is not yogi, he's karma bhogi. Many people say, I'm doing karma. When they say, please come to temple, no, I'm doing karma. You're not doing karma yoga, you're doing karma bhoga. Karma bhoga means work hard and enjoy the result. So karma yoga, it becomes when you understand this result doesn't belong to me, the result belongs to Krishna. And you start sacrificing the result for the pleasure of Krishna. Then jnana yoga is next. When he's sacrificing, mind becomes a bit purified. He start understanding what is God, what is my relation to God. And then still, when he becomes more purified, he can convince, yes, God is there by his cultivation of knowledge. He goes to the forest to meditate upon God. And then he takes darshan of God and he surrenders to God. Krishna is so kind. He's always accompanying me. So karma yoga leads to jnana yoga, leads to ashtanga yoga, leads to bhakti yoga. That's another way to look at it. But in Kali Yuga, there is no time for this step-by-step process. So what acharyas recommend in Kali Yuga, Harinam Vande Sako. In Kannada it is said, just chant the names of the Lord, automatically you develop faith. That what is why karma yogi, jnana yogi, ashtanga yogi, their faith is not as strong as bhakti yogi. Bhakti yogi means he just acts for the pleasure of the Lord. That's all. But you require strong faith for that. But by chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, you develop that faith. Provided anybody does it without offenses, sincerely, yes. So of all the yogis who always abides me in great faith, worshipping me in transcendent loving service, is most intimately united to me in yoga and is the highest of all. So this is what we should dream of. One day we can go to the spiritual world and run behind the Lord like this and eternally be happy. No school to go, no examinations to give, no office to go. Keval Ananda Kanda. Only have fun. That is the spiritual world. Okay. Everybody, is it fine with this? First part of the presentation. No questions? Oh, Premikishori Mataji is there. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Krishna.
Hare Krishna. They have so become, all the classes that have become like that, pin drop silent. They don't make a single. Yesterday, my evening class, I didn't come to know, you know, sometimes the signal stops. I was out of the presentation and I was still speaking. Then I realized I'm on and I went back. They were peacefully chanting Hare Krishna. 10 minutes gap. Everybody is chanting. It's very nice. Chalo, I continue then.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Yeah. I have a question.
Yes,
ma'am. So basically, between Ashtanga Yoga and Bhakti Yoga, what is the distinction on how faith, the practice
faith,
is?
Faith. It lacks faith. Ashtanga Yogi wants to see the Lord before bowing down to him. Bhakti Yogi already has faith. You understand? He will also surrender after taking darshan. But the point is, Ashtanga Yoga doesn't take 6 months. It takes years and years and years. There are cases it has taken very, very long times. So first thing, your body is not so strong in Kali Yuga to live a long time. Secondly, we cannot do those austerities. I tell you, I miss one lunch, I get acidity. That is my condition. And right. You tell me, I have to live in a forest. And tell me, which one of us can live in a forest today? Mm-hmm. Anytime, I tell you, even in the city, light is off and I'm alone in the house, I panic. This is our condition of the mind. Our mind is weak. We don't have so much strength mentally, physically. We are not so strong today. So Krishna is not expecting us to do something which is difficult, more beyond our capacity. And if it was within our capacity, you know, Arjuna, who is actually playing a part of a student, he's just playing a part. He's a great personality. You would not have rejected that. When he's saying, Krishna, I can't do it, actually it's not for him. It's for us, we can. He's an associate of the Lord. He can do anything he wants. Isn't it? If Arjuna is saying, cannot do, there is a strong signal he's giving to us. Don't even attempt about it. Process is not wrong. It's just like a medicine in a medicine shop. Medicine is not wrong. But for the time, the medicine has become difficult now. You know, sir. Yeah, Prem Kishori Mataji can explain now. There is a presentation on yoga. Yes, Prem Kishori Mataji, you can help them go through that.
Prabhu, which one? Which presentation?
And on yoga, little. To introduce to you, Prem Kishori Mataji, those who know, is a very leading doctor in America. You know, in America, to be there itself, people say in heaven. On top of it, to be a big doctor is very rare. And she's so dedicated to, even among all the things, she's trying to spread the message. Isn't it wonderful?
I'm not a big doctor. I feel embarrassed by that.
She's too good, Guruji.
See, already you are not. My class. Chalo, he explain this now.
Oh, so different yugas. Okay, so there are four yugas: Treta Yug, Dwapar Yug, Satya Yug, and Kali Yug. So again, anyone, please tell me what is the recommended mode of sacrifice or self-realization recommended for Treta Yug? What practice of yoga is recommended in Treta Yug for self-realization? Can someone please raise their hand or unmute themselves?
Yajna, meditation, and what about Dwapar Yug? Going to forest and meditate, deity worship, elaborate temple worship.
Yes, thank you. What about Satya Yug?
Yugs, meditation.
Meditation. Thank you. What about Kali Yug? The same process. So every age has a different
chanting. Krishna name.
Chanting.
You don't need to present. They already know.
Chanting God's name.
Yes. Different yoga practices for different yugas. Thank you so much. So Kriteya Dhyayate Vishnu Tretayam Yajato Makhay Dwapare Paricharyayam Kalo Tadhari Kirtanat. So the same process, Kriteya Dhyayate Vishnu, for Treta Yug is Yajato Makhay, and Dwapar Yug is Paricharyam, and then Satya Yug is meditating on the Lord in the heart. Kali Yug, same thing can be done by Hari Kirtanat, Tad Hari Kirtanat. Not Kali Kirtan, not Shiv Kirtan, not Brahma Kirtan, not this Kirtan, that Kirtan, but what Kirtan? Hari Kirtan, yes. I don't have this presentation, Prabhu, so I can't share my screen. Sorry to ask you. Yeah. So Satya Yug, again, as most of you mentioned, meditation on Lord Vishnu. So that was for Satya Yug. Treta Yug, again, performing expensive sacrifices. Very expensive. If the whole wealth of the whole world is put together, we will only sustain few days of worth of our sacrifice that was done in that age. So we are so poor, actually, as compared to people in that age. And then Dwapar Yug, temple worship, elaborate temple worship, not just small temple worship. But the same thing can be achieved in Kali Yuga by... I wish I have this.
Chanting
the holy names of the Lord. So some of the references for the same. So this is an example that if someone has to go to an office and the office is on, let's say, 20th floor, there are two ways to get there. Okay, there are two ways to get there. One is taking this stairs and the other is taking this elevator. What will an intelligent man take?
Elevator.
Thank you. So people who take to Krishna consciousness in this age or Kali Yuga are called as Sumedha. Sumedha. Medha means good brain. And Sumedha means specially good brain because they are taking a elevator to reach to Krishna. So the next slide is about mantra. So the meaning of the word mantra is explained. We use this word very loosely. So what is mantra? Man means mind. And tra means the sound vibration that delivers the mind. You know, it's very interesting. Once I was a part of an interfaith meeting in America, and we had religious leaders from different cult sitting on a podium. Okay, so there was a Muslim, a Jewish, some other small sects, I don't know their names. And then ISKCON leader was there, one of the sannyasis. And Jen. So interestingly, when I looked at all of them, they all had their japa beads. They all had beads. So interestingly, the connection, the way of making connection with the Supreme Personality of Godhead through sound is being propagated in all cults. So it's so powerful. It's not so easy. can go to the next slide, Prabhu, please.
Japa.
So the japa. Japa is something which we do to ourselves, individual. I'm looking for my bead bag. So japa of what? What do we jap? What do we do japa of? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. When it is done alone, then it is called japa. And when it is done with other devotees, then it is called Sankirtan. But this is the mantra which is recommended to deliver the mantra. Can someone mute themselves, please? Deep Ramoth. So Sankirtan is with other devotees and japa is something which we do alone. And Prabhupada recommended. Multiplied by 108 is what Prabhupada recommended for this age. Minimum, that's minimum. We can do more than that. And then there are going to be some references from the Shastras. Why should, like Prabhu was saying, I believe, you believe, this believe, that believe. But we take Shastra Praman. You know, we practice something called evidence-based medicine. Like, what is the evidence behind your practice? Like that, here we are teaching you how to practice evidence-based spirituality. Prabhupada always taught us that we should give Shastra Praman. Immediately you say something, quote it. Quote it where it's coming from because I'm not the authority. So some of the quotes are, Prabhu, your screen is not showing. We are on the participant screen. I should have this. Let me see. Sorry about the delay.
It is not coming now. It should come.
It's coming, Prabhuji.
It's coming,
Prabhuji.
It's coming, Prabhuji.
It's coming.
Maybe there is a lag on my end, Prabhu. Maybe there is a lag here. So if it is coming, can someone please read it for me until my internet uploads it or refreshes it?
Scripture.
It's in Sanskrit.
References.
पूजते भगवान हरि कलयुग जस्ट बाय चैंटिंग द नाम ऑफ द लॉर्ड वी कैन वर्शिप हरि
या नाउ इट्स देयर यस सो दिस इज वन रेफरेंस एंड अनदर रेफरेंस इन द एज ऑफ कलि People should simply chant the holy names of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Should simply chant. So whenever I've been taking classes, I've been telling that when we use communication skills, some words are very strong, like have to, must, should. So it is an order. It's not ordinary. If you really read communication skills, when someone uses a word should, it's a very strong order. People should simply chant the holy names of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That means there is no other way. It's an order. So the next reference is, there's a lag. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Iti Shodashakam Nam Nam Kali Kalmasha Nashanam Natha Paratrayo Payaha Sarva Vedeshu Drishyate. What does this mean? Iti Shodashata Shodashakam Nam Nam. It means after searching through all the Vedic literatures, one cannot find a method of religion more sublime for this age than chanting of Hare Krishna. This is from Kali Santarana Upanishad from Krishna Yajurveda. So searching through all the scriptures. So this is a very strong reference. The next reference, Prabhu, your screen is hanged for me. So do you give me permission to share my screen? Because maybe there's a problem from my end.
Now, are you able to see?
Yes. Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Eva Kevalam. Three times. Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Eva Kevalam. Kalau Nastiyev, 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 Gatiranyata. So three times it's been said, Nastiyev, 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 Gatiranyata. So something which is said three times means it is very, very important, very, very importantly emphasized that there is no other way. There is no other way. And then there is no other way. This is from Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Leela, chapter 17, text number 21. And the next reference is on from Srimad Bhagavatam, 12th canto, 3rd chapter, 51st verse. It's still loading for me, but I have this. Kaler dosh nidhi rajan, asti ek mahan guna, kirtana dev krishnasya, mukta sangha param vrajet. My dear king, although Kali Yuga is full of faults, there is still one good quality about this age. It is that simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, one can become free from material bondage and be promoted to the transcendental kingdom. Simply by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So, Kale Dosh Nidhi Rajan. Nidhi means ocean. Dosh means faults. So it's an ocean of faults. Asti Ek Mahan Guna. There is one good quality. What is the good quality of this age? Simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This is from 12th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Prabhu, for me, your screen is frozen at Kaler Dosh. Oh, yes. Sorry. And then from Bhagavad Gita that we are studying, 10th chapter, 25th shloka. In 10th chapter, Krishna discusses his 82 opulences. Because Arjuna asks, I want to know some of your opulences. So Krishna describes his 82 opulences. And one of them is, Yagna Nam Japo Yagno Asmi. Of sacrifices, I am the chanting of the holy names, Japa. He says, I am the chanting of the holy name. And chapter 25th verse from this study, we'll come to it when we come to the chapter. And then Chaitanya Charitamrita Antalila, chapter 20, text number 16. Nam Nam Akari Bahuda Nijasarva Shakti Statrapita Nyamita Smarane Nakala. Etadishi Tava Kripa Bhagavad Mamapi Durdeva Midrishamiha Jani Nanuraga. See, so many references, my Lord, O Supreme Personality of Godhead. In your holy name, there is all good fortune for the living entity. And therefore you have many names such as Krishna and Govinda. You have invested all your potencies in those names, and there is no hard and fast rules for remembering them. See, there is no hard and fast rule for remembering them. There is no barrier. But what is the barrier? Barrier is my mind. I don't want to do it because I don't have faith. So if somebody wants to begin bhakti, what is the first stage? Faith. Like Prabhu was explaining, Shraddha. There is a bhajan also that Nadia Godrume. There is an island called Nadia. In that, there is a place called Godrum. What happened there? Why is it so famous? Nityananda Mahajan. Nityananda Prabhu started something. What did he start? Nadiya Godrume Nityananda Mahajana Pati Achhe Naam Hatte Jeevana Karat. He started a marketplace of holy name. Who can go there? Everybody can go to a marketplace. There is no restriction. But who will benefit the most? Shraddhavan Jan Hai. Shraddhavan Jan. So who has little bit of a faith will benefit the most. And some of the ways of chanting, some of the ways that we can tell you technically, that we seek the blessings of Panchatattva before we start to chant so that we don't do any offenses. So that Panchatattva Mahamantra is Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advait Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakti Vrinda. And then we start chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So when we chant, chanting means I'm chanting alone, japa. We chant audibly and enough to hear the mantra. And we pronounce each and every name distinctly.
I've told you the charger. Are you ready?
So chanting, and when we are chanting, we are actually just hearing. So chanting and hearing. Let's say I'm saying Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hearing, there is no mind. Prabhupada was asked once, one of his disciples asked that, Prabhupada, when I'm chanting, I'm getting this light, or I'm imagining I'm getting this Krishna's form. You know what Prabhupada said? Prabhupada said, it's okay, just ignore it. So Prabhupada didn't, he said, when we chant, chanting is between the tongue and the ear. There is no mind. That's the meditation. So chant with respect, devotion and concentration, with lot of faith. With lot of faith. That, you know, we are putting so much faith on our worries. Why not on chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra? There is no tax.
So, Mataji, can you show the previous slide, please?
The one, pronounce each name distinctly. This is when we say Hare Krishna, we don't do like this. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Shri, Shri, Shri. Like some people are whispering when they're chanting, but that's not what is recommended. Because the ear will not hear. The ear will hear the mind then. And then we chant with concentration and lot of faith. There is a lag. So we can chant at any place, sitting or walking or facing in any direction. There is no restriction of any of those things. We can chant, preferably we should, we can chant any time, but preferably early morning Brahma Muhurta is recommended. I heard one lecture by one Prabhupada's disciple once. He was talking about it, like chanting early in the morning. And he said, technically, if you think about it, when the sun comes out, we have so many distractions. So many distractions are there when the sun comes out in the sky. So better to chant in the Brahma Muhurta, which is about 1.5 hours before sunrise. But if you can't, then please, it's better to chant than not to chant. And then we can chant either before bath or after bath, preferably after bath, because we will feel fresh and clean and we'll be more able to concentrate. But it can be chanted before bath. Or some, let's say somebody is sick and they can't bath, they can chant in their bed. And then it is recommended to chant by keeping a count, preferably on Tulsi beads, which has 108 beads. Then some of the don'ts of chanting. The don'ts of chanting is, one should not chant only a portion of the Mahamantra. We should not just say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, and then go to the next bead, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Well, Prabhu, can I bring my beads? Because I'll be able to show on it. My bead is just over there. Is it okay, bro? 1 second. I'm sorry. So these are the beads. So we use thumb and the middle finger, because the index finger is used for pointing. So that's, we don't use that. Prabhupada taught us like this. So we hold the bead and we chant the full mantra on one bead. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, and then go to the next bead. Not like we do Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, and the next portion, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare here. No. Each bead gets all 16 syllables. Okay? And then we don't chant on Krishna bead. Yesterday we had Bhakti Vriksha, so we read about Sakshi Gopal. This is a witness bead. This bead is witnessing my chanting. So let's say I start my round on this bead. I go through the whole mala and I end over here. Right? Start here, end here, and I have to start a second round, so I just turn it around. So the last bead becomes the first bead for the second round. And then, Prabhu, for me, your presentation is not coming. Also, one should not chant while reading a book or mobile phone or newspaper or watching TV. That's an offense. See, chanting is not so easy. Chanting has three stages: Naam Aparad, Naam Abhas, and Shuddha Naam. So we are trying to avoid offenses to the holy name. And one of the most important offenses is to be inattentive while chanting. So anything that takes my attention away needs to be avoided if I really want to reach the goal, if I want to develop love for Krishna. So please don't try to multitask while chanting. That's not what a dhyana yogi also does. They're not trying to cook at the same time and trying to do laundry at the same time and then trying to meditate. They're also concentrating. Like that, we also concentrate. What are the benefits of chanting? Some of the benefits of chanting are the freedom from the reactions of sin. When you read 7th chapter Bhagavad Gita, we are going to come across that Rupa Goswami in Nectar of Devotion tells us that our sinful activities are very deep rooted, and there are four types of sinful activities, sinful reactions, sorry, there are four types of sinful reactions. Some of them which we are already suffering from, and another one which are coming very soon, and another one which are still dormant and will take effect later on, and another one which are still in a very seed-like state and will maybe fructify in next life. So they are like four types of reactions, and Krishna consciousness or chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra releases us from all kind of reaction. But of course, we should not chant to get free with the consciousness that I want to get free from the reactions of my sinful activity, and at the same time continue with the unwanted habits. Relief from unwanted drives and habits. People are suffering, right? Somebody knows, they know that smoking is bad and they want to give up. But we actually cannot give up a habit just by wanting to give up. Mind is not, is weak, weak mind. So Krishna consciousness takes us to the soul level, and then we are able to give up unwanted habits, smoking, drug addiction. And this is a byproduct. This is not the reason we chant, but byproduct that our devotees are naturally very happy. So it gives us freedom from anxiety and stress. There's a psychologist. His name is Dr. David Wolf in Florida University. He actually did his PhD thesis on how Hare Krishna chanting releases one from anxiety and stress. I have his 300 paper. How he studied that, how it actually Hare Krishna chanting changes the neurobiology of the neurons in the brain, how it works. So these devotees look happy, right? They're not looking like a pauper. Prabhupada was asked when he was going to Hawaii, one priest in plain clothes came to him and said, Swamiji, can I ask you a question? And Prabhupada said, yes. And then he said, how come your disciples, the faces are so bright? And Prabhupada said, because the process is so nice. Because face is the index of the mind. And we get to the platform of real happiness. It's not fake. It's not dependent on something outside. It's not that only if I have this much bank balance, only if I watch this movie, only if I have this house, I'll be happy. This happiness is internal job. And it goes on increasing. Anandam buddhi vardhanam. It goes on increasing. It doesn't stop. Once we get there. And then peace of mind, real happiness, enlightenment. So Hare Krishna consciousness means knowledge. Just by chanting Hare Krishna, Prabhupada has said, if someone is really chanting Hare Krishna, all the Vedic knowledge will be revealed to that person from the heart. It's a process of revelation. But we have to be at that stage. And then next one is some of the testimonies. What are the most common, most famous people in the history who have taken up chanting are saying about their experiences. So George Harrison, he was a famous musician in UK from Beatles group. He came in touch with the devotees. Actually, devotees got him. And then he became Krishna conscious. And then he said, it's really a process of having realization of God. That's his testimony. And the next one is John Claude Haliche is a very famous businessman in France. Everything started happening to me when I began chanting Hare Krishna. So that's his testimony that he realized. And this is one of my favorite, Albert Bush Ford. Chanting Hare Krishna has made a tremendous impact in my life. So he actually is a Prabhupada disciple. See, he has Prabhupada's photo behind. And he has dedicated his life to Srila Prabhupada. And he's a very key person behind making Temple of Vedic Planetarium in Mayapur in India. He's a co-owner of Ford Motors. Then Andy Desai, the leading steel person on all these companies he's the owner of. I have been chanting Hare Krishna for many years and have never found anything more pleasurable. See, these are millionaires. Okay, some people may be thinking that my happiness will manifest if I have millions and millions of money, and then I'll be able to buy. But these are millionaires, and they're giving testimony that I have never found anything more pleasurable. Never. And they were, sorry. And the next one is Mafat Lal. Chanting Hare Krishna has helped me face all ups and downs in my life with great confidence and peace of mind. He's very closely associated with ISKCON Juhu in Mumbai. He's a devotee there, Hrishikesh Mafat Lal. Then this very famous Dutch model, Annie Schaffers. Chanting helped me give up bad habits. It changed my vision of things. See, she looks happy, right? Even though she doesn't look like this anymore. She's wearing a sari. She's on the Nagar Sankirtan with the devotees. But she looks peaceful and happy. And another model from Europe, Vicky Overton. She was very famous in her time. By starting to chant Hare Krishna, I feel tremendous happiness. And this is one of the army officers from United States, Bruce Kleinberg. My outlook towards life is a lot more brighter after starting to associate with Hare Krishna devotees and chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Then famous Italy's top furniture designer, Marco Ferrini. He is a devotee. He said, chanting makes me feel close to God. And this is Dr. David Wolf. He is the one I was talking to you about. Maha Mantra significantly reduces stress, depression, and mode of ignorance, and considerably increases the mode of goodness. So he has actually dedicated his thesis to this particular topic, and I have his thesis paper. Then printing executive Paul Blyer. When I'm stressed out, I chant. It's one thing which charges my batteries. It clears my mind and brings me back to focus. Mrs. Sally Raleigh, merchantizer. When I'm nervous, I find chanting very calming. I don't get shaken up by little things, at little things. Then Ramesh Lal, Toronto Health Spa proprietor. Chanting Hare Krishna and reading authorized books on Krishna consciousness has brought me great peace. So please, you can also chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, and be happy. Please take up, there is no need for any delay. Krishna consciousness is Ahetuki Apratihata. Ahetuki means cannot be stopped by anything and it is not dependent on anything. It just depends on my own determination. Thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Mataji, can you show the first slide of the first chant?
First slide of the chapter?
Yeah. No, not the first slide of the chapter. The slide where you showed the how you have to start the chanting. The first, the Chaitanya Prabhu.
The Panchatattva Mantra, Shri Krishna Chaitanya.
Yeah, that one.
Okay.
The beginning of the chant. How do you begin the chanting?
Yes. Panchatattva Maha Mantra.
Yeah.
You see it now?
I think yes. I can see
Krishna Chaitanya. Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhara, Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktivrinda.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mataji, why we have to turn around while chanting after finishing one round?
Oh, because this is a witness bead. This bead, see, there is a bead between, right? You can see?
Yes.
This bead is called as witness bead. It's a bead that is witnessing my chanting. It's a Krishna bead. So yeah, we don't chant Krishna bead.
Why can't you continuously do it after 108? Again start the same clockwise.
Out of respect. We don't go over Krishna. Out of respect.
So every time we have to change that anti-clockwise and clockwise, is it?
Yes, so the last bead of one round becomes the first bead of second round, and then that they go on. So it is a respect. When I started chanting, I didn't know this that this has to be done. I used to jump, but then the devotees told me later that we don't do that. Prabhu, is there any other reason?
is logical. Because suppose we are turning around, you will be so conscious, I finished one round. Otherwise, you will be just going over. It's logical. It will make you very conscious. See, the level of concentration in chanting, if it is very less, then we chant like this, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, because we are not knowing, the finger goes independent. So at least one level of concentration where we are not only counting, so disciplining ourselves, at the same time, there is one minimum level of concentration needed, one is over, so it helps. Always the best way to chant is to know, I am doing in the order of the Acharya. Then your chanting is pure chanting. So they ask Srila Prabhupada, why you come to America? My guru told me. Always so simple. So always, why you're chanting? Prabhupada told me. Acharya told me. Then your chanting is, you'll always do chanting. Otherwise, I'm funny, enjoying, then it is not the best way. I've been told to do. That's a very nice spiritual life, the attitude. I've been told to do. Then you chant very nicely.
Prabhuji, one more thing.
So, Mataji?
You were telling that I had an understanding that we can chant anytime, but not really required focus of chanting like in the kitchen or in the hall or going around. So is that true, or we have to sit at one place and focus and chant?
See, the concentration will be better if you sit down and close your eyes. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. That's my preferable. Different people chant different ways. But when I chant, I see that there is nothing else I am focused on. See, suppose you are walking and chanting, that's also nice. But many times difficult to concentrate. Then you're looking at everything. What's the traffic? What is this? What is that? Isn't it? So if the pleasure of chanting at any time come, it has been when I have been totally absorbed with no distraction. Okay, make sense?
Yeah, I got it. Basically, I was told in my previous classes, saying that it can be chanted anytime. There's no restriction for this Maha Mantra.
So there's no rules, no time. But you know, certain conditions are preferable. No rules, no time. Yes. Suppose you can go in for a morning walk. So many people in India are walking in a morning walk. Why don't they chant? It's easy, no? Nowadays, a big fashion. But Vedic time, generally, special morning time, people will not do anything else. Today, exercises become like too much people are focused on that. So they can sit and chant. That is better. Very attentive. You will get, you know, don't think of doing exercise or bodily health at the japa time. That is the most precious time for you. That is for time for the soul. So therefore, if you can hold your attention, close your eyes and hear every word, Hare Krishna, that's the best.
Just a follow-up question on the same thing. What about if you put iPod, most of the people do while walking, they put in the earphones and keep hearing this chanting. That is good or no?
See what happened, chanting is, you have to do it. Correct. Not that this is a sadhana for you. Your mouth is involved, your ear is involved. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Correct? But true, when you are going for a walk and all this thing, you can have many bonus things. I call it always white account and black account. So the white account is the quality chanting that is what you're trying to do every day, 4 round, 8 round, 16 round, 1 round. That should be with super concentration. Another black account bonus, you are cooking, you are walking, you are bathing, do it. It's never going to be a loss. Chanting is always a benefit. Ajamila chanted, you were not even thinking about the Lord that time. Benefit. Always a credit, never a debit. But then concentration will help, isn't it? That is special. Some rounds should be with very high concentration. You fix up how much you do that. The rest all through the day, you can just keep uttering the name wherever you are sitting in the bus softly, Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
They are already devotees.
When Nama Aparadha.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, you are talking about you can chant every time black account and white account. So I am telling that what about the Nama Aparadha? When Nama Aparadha applies to the devotees?
Okay. So now, in the white, see what happens, we have a nama fixed up when I'm going to chant so much rounds. Okay? There it is very, very serious that I don't do distracted. ठीक है. See, Krishna knows what you are doing.
Yes,
when you are doing japa, you are supposed to be the guru adesha, acharya adesha, they do japa, you are sitting. That is done with very high concentration. Okay, at that time, your distraction will not be encouraged.
Yes,
but other time, you are walking, you are in a lift. There is never a loss chanting the name of the Lord. Krishna, Krishna, how are you? Krishna, Krishna, you are fine. Krishna. Never a loss. Never a Thank you. That's a very intelligent question.
Prabhuji, we have to chant only Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Only that we have to chant, or we have to chant before that one also.
Which one? The Shri Krishna Chaitanya? The Shri Krishna Chaitanya mantra, we are taking blessings of, you know, isn't our process always taking blessings and then doing? We do that anything? We begin our day, we take blessings of the Lord and go. Sometimes we take blessings of elders also, isn't it? That's our culture. You're trying a big thing, you go to, please bless me. But similarly, we are taking blessings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And another reason is that there will be offenses in chanting. I have not introduced you to, there will be mistakes we do. We will not be concentrating. We don't even know what I am chanting. So many things are happening. So when you're chanting the Panchatattva mantra, we are pardoned. We are taking blessing. We are entering the japa in the right attitude. The Sri Krishna Chaitanya is referring to the Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, Nityananda Prabhu. The five personalities here are seeking their blessings before beginning the chanting. So your whole chanting begins with right attitude.
We have to start every time.
Every mantra you start, every mantra 108 times. Before you start, we seek the blessings. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhara, Shri Vasadi Gaurava. And in chanting the Panchatattva mantra, there is no offense because they don't take it off. They're very kind.
Guruji, and Prabhu, for the beginners, like chanting for the beginners, it's not that easy because they don't have control on their minds, because there's already something running in their mind in the morning hours. I have to go to office, I have to go to this, kids has to be dropped in school. So how, for the beginners, basically for the beginners, how you prefer, what kind of controls they should have when they sit in a place in the morning hours when they do chanting?
They should chant loudly. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, because the earlier the stage, the more difficult is the mind. Anna? That's you said. So the hearing will be very difficult. Chanting is for the soul. The soul has to hear the mantra. But the mind is crowded. It's like in a fish market you are sitting. You cannot hear anything. Correct? So therefore, I remember when I joined the temple, I just from Infosys came out. And next day I'm in temple. It's not that I become a saint. The mind is so crowded. So I should take permission of the president. If I sit and chant here, nobody can hear the chanting. Because you should not disturb other people chanting when you're chanting. So I used to go to the construction site and chant there. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And that's our effort. So my experience is, if they're finding difficult, chant. And your own house, you know, I hope nobody will obstruct. Chant loudly as much we can do. As much practically possible till the neighbors barge in.
Thank you. Guruji, thank you, Prabhuji.
Guruji, one question, Guruji. In Gayatri Mantra, we go with the process of japa. That is, even you say it yourself, not loud. But here you advocate only chanting with loud voice. And that would probably, in some situations, prevent you from even chanting. Is japa forbidden?
That's why I said, as loudly as practically possible. See, Gayatri japa, we give in ISKCON 7 Gayatri mantras, not one. You only know Kam Gayatri, we give 7. But after some time, Gayatri japa is done on the mind, not outside. Correct? And to do in the mind, you should be really peaceful. So in ISKCON, the way we initiate people is that we have split the initiation into two parts. Generally, Diksha in any society in Indian community, any community, is one part. We give the Gayatri, correct? In ISKCON is two parts. One part we give only the Nama, Hari Nama of the Lord, and let him chant for 1 or 2 years till his mind becomes calm. And then we give the Gayatri. Because if the mind is not calm, he cannot do it. I've seen some people, one person was chanting Gayatri for 1 hour. And I went to him, what happened to him? So what can I do? Just 10 times I can't hear that. Within second time, mind get. And the moment you think of something else, you have to repeat it. Now it's gone. You know. And so we are doing, but you are not in a capacity to do it. Therefore, when you chant Hari Nama, the Gayatri Japa also improves. You understand?
Okay. Thank you.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. So generally we need to do 16 times a day, 16 rounds.
One question.
Oh, wonderful. Hari, you're ready, you do. I know so many people from first day they did 16. It's possible.
No, I mean, I'm doing for the past 2 months, so I'm touching 10, 12 and 16. So that's the way I'm going on.
The difference between 10 and 16 is 100 times, you know, not 2 times. Because correct, 16 correct. Is the order of the Acharya. The moment you come under the protection of the Acharya, really, that's what I'm saying, chant on the order. See, the dose is fixed by the Acharya and Krishna is so keen, so happy when you're following his devotee. Krishna is so happy. He wants us to process like that, proceed like that.
Okay, good.
So all
Hare Krishna married. Prabhuji.
Yes. All devotees only here. Okay. Yes, Hare Krishna.
Hare please Krishna Prabhuji.
So many of you may have a strong question. Please ask. Don't feel anything. True, if you speak something offensive, I'll bang you. But none of you mind it, I know. So yesterday somebody had a Krishna class. But Krishna has no form. I gave him like, what? Telling you gone crazy. He didn't mind it at all. I was saying, so nice person. Yeah.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. This is Ashwini from USA.
Okay. Yeah, Krishna is also from USA only. Ha, tell me.
Why we would cover our hand while doing japa?
That's a very, very deep reason. Simple is actually, see what happened, not covering. Simple logical reason is that when you're chanting, simple, that the japa bead will be, you know, on the floor. Correct? So better put inside a bag. More advanced reason will tell you after some time. There is simple reason you can understand. The japa bead will go on the floor. Okay? Isn't it simple? If you're not having a japa bag, then how will you chanting with two hands? The one hand becomes free. And a japa bead is kept safe. Other reason, not now. We are just in the beginning of this class. Any simple reason you have? That's a detailed reason why we keep it covered. Yes, Ashwini Mataji, you are also chanting for some time?
Yes, Prabhuji.
You write on the mail, I can answer to you. Because of the audience, it will be difficult to understand immediately everything. Yeah, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. There were the other gentleman who was earlier saying that I have started since 2 months. Just wanted to ask, how has it changed or benefited?
Hare Bol! Who was the person who was chanting since 2 months, 16 rounds? Yeah. Please come up.
This is Kalyan. Yeah, this is Kalyan from Hyderabad. Yeah, it's been very good. Like, my brother has told me about this because he's a great, he used to tell me he has already studied Bhagavad Gita 2 times and he's studying all the Srimad Bhagavatam books also. He has purchased around worth of 10,000 worth of books of Sri Krishna. And he has dedicated this Bhagavad Gita book to me. And I started reading for the past 2 months. And also started reading this Maha Mantra. And the whatever you have told us, like do the Japa Mantra first. I mean, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasudeva Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. That one and next the Hare Krishna mantra. So these all have been told by my brother to me. And I'm very lucky that I've started doing this for the past 2 months and it was very good for me. And my mind was very fresh and it was cool, very, very good.
Good. Any you other eyewitness? Fresh. Any other person who is chanting? We don't need so many photographs. Your photographs are here. We can put their photographs.
So Hare Krishna Prabhuji, I've just started chanting since I started the course and I'm already feeling very pleasant.
Very nice. Thank you. And so my
just
request
to confirm,
my request is you chant, increase the concentration. This is my realization. There is no limit to how much you can concentrate. And the Lord, this actually is very simple process, no? Every class, what I say, anything, chant Hare Krishna. But do that is not easy, to hear every word. It's not easy. It's very challenging, very, very challenging. But that is where you show your devotion to the Lord. Simple, no? Kaliyuga is not asking to live without food in the forest or do any gymnastics, nothing. Wherever right. you are, chant very attentively. So he has made it so easy. But trying to hear is where you show your love for the Lord. Trying to hear. Yeah. Just like say, I come to your place and you want to be attentive, isn't it, when a guest mm-hmm. comes. So similarly, when you're chanting the name, you're inviting the Lord. Then you should be very attentive. Hear a word by word. And there is no limit how much you can try to concentrate. And I tell you, my experience of sweetness in the chanting has always been when I put my real energy into hearing. Don't put into, you know, I've been thinking Krishna's form. Your whole thing is a chanting process is between mantra. Your mantra mm-hmm. meditation. It's a meditation on the mantra. But increase the meditation is no limit on it. I never found right. that how much I can improve on it. Still, there is so much more to go. Hare Krishna.
I have a follow-up question on that. So this, your recommendation of 16 chants is in one sitting? 16 you have to complete?
You can break it up. It's. I tell you, if you start chanting, it's like Prema Kishori Mataji is there. Ask her. She has been holding for the last 20 years. She can't give it up. Nobody watching that. She has a medical profession to do. But she will not sleep without doing that. It becomes part of you. You feel like you are empty in the stomach if not completed. It's so important. Sometimes, right. some reason you're not able to do, you feel totally suffocated. I've not finished my chant. It becomes part of your life.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
And it doesn't cost anything. The greatest thing, it doesn't cost anything. No cost, no expenditure, no overdose, no side effect, nothing. What a medicine it is.
Just gain of pleasure and happiness.
See, it's a very funny situation. If suppose you go to the airport and there are two aircraft standing. One aircraft is free and everything in the aircraft is free. It is going to Vaikuntha, but people don't climb on it. The other aircraft, you have to pay heavily the ticket and inside everything is charged. People board on that. So the way to Vaikuntha, no temple will charge you anything. You can enter a temple free of cost, correct? But people don't go. They'll go to bar, pay and enter a bar and keep paying all night and go to hell after that. So people pay to go to hell and people are always given free passes to Vaikuntha. They don't want it. It's a very funny situation. So the chanting is such an easy process and so inexpensive process. We somehow say, no, I have to put my hand here, put my leg there. There was one devotee, I remember, we had a program. And he said, no, if you tell so simply, they don't take it. So he made them do some gymnastics. Okay, all of you sit down, we are in a program in auditorium. Now take a deep breath inside. Then release it. He made them do 4 or 5 times this. Then now chant, Hare Krishna, because people don't like simple. They want some complication. But why Krishna kept it so simple? I tell you the reality is, practically, this all we can do. Our life is so complicated today. We have so many anxieties, so many responsibilities, so many distractions. This is all we can actually do. So Krishna has not asked us more. But somehow we overestimate our strength. And as they say, okay, I'll do this. But end of the day, you go after a few days, they're not able to do. But this is something you can easily do. And Krishna is not expecting. It's like super discount sale.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yeah.
I think I saw that slide saying that still today in Kali Yuga, we still do the deity puja, we still do the yajnas, from the advices from our Purohit or Pandit or Bhatji for various reasons, and we perform various functions, puja, like Satyanam puja, Ganoma, everything. So by now, I want to know if Kali Yuga is the only Maha Mantra to be done, should we completely stop of doing those, but not everyone is doing today?
Now see what happens, understand, beautiful. This question is, Variyam! Not only that, when you come to temple, in ISKCON temple, there also we are doing Variyam for the Lord. You can hear the conch blowing all the time. I'm in a temple sitting. Can you hear or not? So what?
Yeah, I was about to ask you that again.
So you're questioning why we do. See, on the foundation of the Harinama, there is a kirtan going on. So Archana is done on the foundation of Harinama. There can be some yagnas done on the foundation of Harinama, but the foundation is Harinama. Even Pujari, before we enter the altar, we do Manas Puja. That is meditation. We are meditating on worshipping the Lord. But the foundation is Harinama. So the foundation of Harinama, there is some archana, but not elaborate temple worship. We are incapable. We don't have the resources and money and the manpower to do it. You understand this point? So simple, generally at home, what we do, not the elaborate. You must be knowing even your ancestors, so many rules are there even for a small puja you to do. Correct? That becomes difficult today. The foundation of Harinama, simple worship is recommended.
So should we again follow up, same question continuing, that I did not get much clarity, but again I'm seeking with you. So should we, if like a Satyanarayana puja, which we do on the Purnima day, right? I mean, in that day, should we do it or should we not do it? Rudra Maharudra Havani.
Vishnu, we are going to encourage that. Why we will discourage? Okay. Same Lord Vishnu we are worshipping, no? Krishna and Vishnu are same. So why we will discourage?
Yes. So
okay, what I'm saying is that, the first thing is that I tell you, I understood your question. Chhodna nahi jodna is the first principle for me through the course. I don't want anybody to stop anything you're doing. Because also socially will not be acceptable also. People will be wild at you. So chhodna nahi jodna, let it go on what is going on. You add Harinama to it. Okay? As Harinama comes in, actually it is totally sufficient. Namna. But why is it along with Harinama the Pancharatra is kept by the Acharyas? Of the Goswami, the disciples of Lord Chaitanya, they said no, with Harinama some Pancharatra should be there. Because Pancharatra is deity worship. Harinama is Bhagavad Vidhi, Pancharatra Vidhi. Harinama has no rules. I told you a practical example. When I came to Mangalore 2002, at that time, I did not put any deities because I had very less manpower. But I saw nobody is coming for aartis. Nobody. But then I brought small deities. Then everybody is coming in time. And not only that, when deities are there, you don't come for darshan in unwashed clothes. Takes bath, the property put tilak. They're coming for darshan, no? They come in a proper, presentable situation. So it helps. When aarti of the Lord is going on, people come and they sit down. And in India, for preaching, practical preaching purposes also, do people not accept a place as temple? There is no deities. What do you say? You go to a temple and there is no deities. They say, what kind of temple is this? What are you worshipping here? So Indians want deities. And also Pancharatra Vidhi and Bhagavad Vidhi should go together. But that Pancharatra Vidhi is where what we do is guided by Narad Muni, which is very simple. Narad Pancharatra, very simple, but authorized. Narada is a great authority. We do what we follow is Narada Pancharatra, not Sri Pancharatra, which are very, very, agamas are very, very detailed. Very simple. But it is authorized process of worship. What you follow. There is, you can, if you want to know about deity worship, you can know about ISKCON deity worship, deityworship.com. There is a website. At home, how to do is there. The rules and regulations are there for deity worship. Can you see the deityworship.com? A full website is there. And you go inside the website, detail, you see, this how the, it is. I tell you, very rarely you will see deities decorated the way we decorate. We spend hours in temples. At home, you cannot do that standard. So what standard we can do at home? What are the temples? See, temples, elaborate deity worship does happen in temple. But the support is always Harinama. And we have full-time brahmacharis, you know, who do all this thing. How much time it will take for the alankara and other thing for the deities? Correct? See, you see that? Festival presentations.
I got your answer. Be saying that chodna nahi jodna hai. So I got it.
Look at, see, this is the way we do it in temple. All upcharas are done. Argya is offered. All these things go out in temple. But at home, it will be difficult. So basic worship is start off at home. This is home worship. Everybody
can do. Hare Krishna. Till we get the Jabamala, can we
website can. And download all the free resources that are available for you. You can download all the mantras, everything, detailed way. See, commencing the worship is in ISKCON, at home, the rules, all FAQs, everything is there.
Thank you, Guruji, for this information. This was always a question for me from almost 25 days.
What is the question?
Thank you so much.
Prabhuji, I have a question.
The same question, whether we could do other pujas and homams.
Prabhuji, I have a question. I have been already practicing Shivanama Stuti daily. Can I add along with this?
I am not telling you to stop anything, please. Add Nama of the Lord. And Lord Shiva will be very, very happy. Ara. Mukti Pradata Sarvesham Vishnu Evana Samshaya. He said, nobody, there is no doubt, only Vishnu can save you. Mukti only he can give you. Vishnu Evana Samshaya. Aradhana Vapi Sarvesham. Once Parvati gets worried, because always he's chanting something. What are you doing? He said, Aradhana Vapi Sarvesham Vishnu Aradhanam Param. Among all the worship, Vishnu is highest. Tasmat Parataram Hei. Even greater than worshipping Vishnu is worship his devotees.
Will we get can we do chanting with Gasla? That can we do chanting? Will we get
the? I didn't get your question. What is the question?
Till we get the beef, no, that we can.
Oh, yes. If you are in India, you write to me, I'll send you the beats. I have already given on the website this resource for you. In India, if you want. Because today, advisable, please don't go outside. It's very dangerous. Okay. But you know, what happens is that suddenly, even sometimes, the city lockdowns are there. So I made a system. See the beads. Yeah, Japamala. I can pack and send you the transportation cost, everything. Within 50, it can be covered. Even in Delhi, it has reached when I send. But time, it is depends on, you know, the situation is on the way. If the city is blocked, state is blocked, Delhi is blocked, that's we are going through a pandemic situation. You can use, generally, in every puja room, one mala will be there in India. Any Hindu has some mala. You can chat on that. Isn't it? Whatever number it has, use it for counting. Sometimes it is 54 bit, 27 bit, whatever you have, you can use it till you get a beat and let the situation improve. When I was in hostel, this thing, I have a time to chat. But where in hostel you get a beat? So I used to use a calendar. I used to use a calendar. 1, 2, 31 are there. Then again, start somehow, I used to make it up. You can do something. At presently, the situation is a little drastic. So don't wait for mala to start. Start chanting immediately. Principle was to keep a count. Somehow keep a count. You know, previously we used to keep a count
in fingers.
Your fingers are there. Krishna has given you finger with all marking lines.
Thank you.
So Prabhuji, can we use any pearl mala or any other bead mala that we have at home?
Anything. You saw the video I showed you yesterday. They were wearing some red beads, something. They didn't have anything. Some wood in. Where in America they had Tulsi that time? Nothing. And Acharya landed. Some beads made of something. That is that.
Important. And it doesn't have to be a certain number? Or can it be? Does it have to
any
be a
number,
certain number?
Any number. Any number. But my request is reach 1728 quickly. As fast you can do that. That's a dose recommended. That becomes a kavacha. Kavacha means nothing will go beyond it. You become such strength of mind. See, what happens to us, let us be honest, at least it happens to me. If I have not chanted, my kavacha is down. So any unwanted desire, I pick up and I become disturbed. When the kavacha is up, nothing will touch me. Then I feel confident. What a confidence.
Anji.
When you know you have a process which gives you enough strength, without getting distracted, you can go on.
Prabhuji, do we need to...
Yeah, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, do we need to clean the beads frequently or sometime? Just we'll see beads. So if we say, let me say, if we attend a funeral of a relative, we come back, we change our clothes. So at that time, do we need to clean the beads?
Generally, what I've seen is that when you go to the holy places, you wash the bead with the holy water. That I've seen. But I've not seen somebody particularly washing the bead after some, I do not know. So that I will have to check up. You write to me in my Gmail, any question like that, I will ask my authority. I will have to ask my senior. Your question is intelligent question, but to be giving a definite answer. But generally, Bhagavad Vidhi involves no rules. Pancharatra Vidhi has rules. So chanting is a part of Bhagavad Vidhi. It should not have any rules. Because being part of Bhagavad Vidhi, anything doesn't have rules. Chanting, just like I'm speaking to you all, no rules. I can sit on any direction and do it. But Pancharatra Vidhi, when I'm doing Gayatri, that I have to be particular direction, particular time on the Sandhya, isn't it? Pancharatra Vidhi, I have to wear clean clothes, unstitched clothes. So many rules are there in Pancharatra Vidhi.
Prabhuji, we have to increase our count slowly, or we can directly do it 1,000 times, or we have to go 108 to 16 like that, or we can go directly to 16.
You should take care, see the time, because already your time will be filled up for 24 days, 24 hours, that's how we live. So you'll not be able to suddenly able to create time also, isn't it? Create time, actually time is there. Enough time is there, everybody. I've not found one person